Alright, welcome to another video about mapping with me. I'm Victor Temprano. I'm the owner of Mapster. This is my company here. So today we're going to be talking about a pretty common problem that people are running into when they first are using Mapbox, and that's dealing with zoom extent. And you might not actually know what it is, but maybe you found this video by searching for zoom problems. So zoom extent means that look how this disappears at my different levels. So maybe I have this data and I've put it into Mapbox and now it won't show up when I'm zoomed out. That's a pretty big problem because, you know, you generally expect your data to be visible. So the reason that this is happening is that the data is too complicated and Mapbox doesn't automatically have the ability to just like make it visible at every level. It's complicated why, but basically these are images and too much data makes it too hard. You gotta squish too much into too small a space and it just breaks. So you end up having it just not render. Now we can find out the actual zoom extent of a given tile set by going to it after we upload it. And we see, yes, its zoom extent here is zoom 8 to zoom 14. And if we were to go back to the style and zoom out, we'd see that that's where it disappears, is at zoom 8. So I originally got my data from here, and it's a shapefile. So I'm just downloading it here again. Well, the fundamental problem is that the data is too complicated, and that maybe it needs to be simplified, or it needs to be reduced somehow, or rendered in a different way. So there's a couple ways to approach it. One is with a great tool called MapShaper. MapShaper allows you to do a lot of things with data. You can do a lot of kind of previews of your data, or just view it. You can change it, you can simplify it. And simplifying, it's exactly what we're going to do. So we can see here, we get no background map, but we can see the data. And some of this data we probably don't need in this much detail. So if we were to simplify here and just choose whatever version you want, we can see that reducing it even 50% does very little. I don't even notice a change. It's only around there when we get to around 20. And what you could do then is go to export, export it as a shapefile if you wanted, re-upload it into Mapbox as another tile set, and then have the two tile sets showing in your style and just have them visible at different levels. And if you need to do more specific filtering with your shapefiles and stuff like that, you know, head in here and take a look at MapShaper's reference. They have an expansive reference if you're kind of a techie person. But if you're just doing it and you're just a user interface person, you don't know, you know, tech stuff very well, the simplification tool here is going to serve you the best. Now, if you are dealing with large data sets and it's more complicated and you're able to do a little bit more work on it, Tippecanoe ultimately is going to be very helpful because it renders right to Mapbox's own files format, which is MB tiles, Mapbox tiles. And it does take a little knowledge to use, and unfortunately it also takes OS X. The installation process is a little painful. You have to make sure you have a few different pieces installed. But once you get through all that, I'm not going to go through it here. Once you get through all that, you have a variety of options. So number one, you need to make sure you have a GeoJSON. So if we're working from here, we can't use the shapefile. So I'm going to export this as a GeoJSON. And there we go. It's right there in my downloads folder. And if I have Tippecanoe, what I can do is actually specify the zoom levels I want. Here, ZG means basically the best, the farthest zoom that is reasonable with the data. As it says here, a maximum zoom level that should be high enough to reflect the precision of the original data. Now you can get around that with a variety of other tools. So this is really where it comes into really huge data sets. For instance, when I work with whole continents of streets, I need to be able to reduce that as much as possible. It might be 50 gigabytes the file. Now you have some particular filters that are quite helpful, and that's here dropping fractions of features. So if you have a huge file, you may need to drop the densest ones or drop parts of them. I just say, I'm not going to go over these in detail, but I just say, come here and check these out for different flags, different options on your Tippecanoe work. But let's do one quick, easy Tippecanoe version. So we're going to do this as ZG. Drop densest as needed, and we're just going to try to get the zoom extent out to a place that makes sense. I'm going to open that and just change the file name to something a little easier. So I'll just call it Eerie. Okay, and we'll paste this in, and we're going to change the GeoJSON to Eerie, and it's just called Eerie.json, and we're going to put it out to Eerie.mbtiles. And what this is doing is it's running Here, dropping the densest ones, the densest parts of our features, whenever it's needed in order to have a good zoom level that still is okay with the precision of the original data. So it's a little bit magical. This will fire through really fast because that was a very small file, but if you have a very large file, that might take quite some time. So now we should have this MB tiles, and you see it's a very small file, less than a megabyte, whereas our original here is already 4 megabytes, which again is a relatively small file. So we come back to our tile sets, we upload in our MB tiles, and you have to wait a second while this uploads and processes. Let's load in our new layer. So we have it in here. There we go. Geography reasons with the Lake Erie contours. And as we can see, it comes up. It's a little weird. We have to make sure it's not a fill, but it's a line, just in this case. And let's add that layer. So we can see we're at 8.1, so we should be able to see the old one anyway. But now when we zoom out, ta-da, we can indeed see it. And how far out does it go? Well, it goes out all the way to zoom level 2. Well, that's not too bad. That seems like a pretty reasonable place. So in this case, Tippecanoe took care of it pretty easily without extra commands, and now we're able to style that. I hope that helped you get over your zoom extent problems, and if you have more troubles, just leave me a note, or if there's some great tool that I left out, leave it in the comments. And definitely check out my Mapbox course if you need to know more about using Mapbox Studio or Mapbox GLJS or any of that stuff.